Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Revelio.
Cannot win, but don't be shy, for I can't wait to watch you try.
Revelio.
What are you up to now?
Revelio. Rebellion. Let me open. Revelio. 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 Incendio. Revelio.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio. Revelio. Incendio. Accio. Revelio.
always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio. Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient.
Incendio. Revelio. Revelio.
I'm sorry.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Call upon Sir Cadogan.
Accio. Revelio.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Accio. Revelio. Accio.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
Off to couch a hog's head.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio. Reparo. Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
That's it.
That hut is behind me. I promise.
Revelio. 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 Accio. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Travel was before I invented flu powder.
Another house token for the house chest. That's it. I'm making good progress with those tokens.
Revelio. Revelio.
Seems that's off limits to me.
It would make him look completely incompetent, which he is.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wigan Weld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumor.
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
He did say that. He wants me to get more ingredients to brew another potion.
Brilliant! You, my friend, have been presented with an extraordinary opportunity. I'm Gareth, by the way. Gareth Weasley, bit of a prodigy with potions, if I do say so myself.
Pleasure to meet you. Wait, are you related to Professor Weasley?
She's my aunt. Keeps too close an eye on me for comfort. Ugh. But she can't be everywhere. Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single whooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'll get you the Fwooper Feather, as long as you're certain Sharp won't miss it.
I assure you he won't. Fwooper Feathers aren't that valuable. Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
A well-prepared... potion stations organized and free of clutter.
Here's the Fwooper Feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you! This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Edurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Proficiency in potions are two things that cannot be rushed. Have patience and be thorough.
Now we add the mallow sweet, and that's odd. What's happening? Wait, it's not supposed to. Ah!
Get it! Not again. Oh!
Now! Dragon dog! What happened?
Well done, Gareth.
My Wiganwell potion's utter rubbish. Wish I could just. Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor. Again, Mr. Weasley did not do this on his own. His accomplice will answer to me as well.
Yeah.
I brewed an Adura's potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm sorry, Professor. I was merely trying to help a friend.
Taking responsibility for one's actions does go a long way with me. I shall assume that you've learned a lesson. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical, given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day. Class is dismissed.
Hello. That was an interesting class.
Thanks to you. Wasn't precisely what I had in mind, but it was still brilliant. I appreciate your help. I hope Sharp wasn't too disagreeable when you handed in your potion. Heard him talking about taking responsibility.
Professor Sharp was annoyed, but we sorted it out. No harm.
Cheers to that. He probably had a good chuckle after we left. Sharp may seem gruff, but I'd bet a few galleons he blew up a potion or two in his day. Best be off. Next time we talk, I promise, fewer explosions.
Greetings, young Slytherin. Scrope knows about the old book you found for Professor Fink. Scrope can help you. And you can help Scrope. Get to the courtyard past the pendulum. If you don't know it, you'll see it easy enough. And don't tell anyone what you're up to. Especially Professor Black.
Revelio.
Heard you're defending Hogsmeade against trolls. Duncan owes his reputation to you.
Revelio.
Lumos.
The unfairness of being hung here.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Oh, if you catch a whiff of anything, I mean, should...
Accio. Revelio. Accio. Revelio. Revelio.
I hate to see a creature get put down like that. But trolls have no business in Hogsmeade.
Revelio.
Oh, if Black hadn't cancelled it, we would have been looking for the blasted thing in first place.
Where are you? Revelio.
You're saying it wrong. Oh, Revelio.
Much better.
Oh, shut up. Wait. Accio. He's ruined my entire school year. I hope a puffskin goes up his nose and snatches his brain.
It had poisoned the poor beast.
What sort of headmaster doesn't allow sport?
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio.
Scrope? Who is Scrope?
Revelio.
pumpkins. Ah, I think I know just the place. Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Down to the water's edge. This had better not be a trick. Incendio! Accio! Incendio! This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful. Revelio! What do you have in store for me this time? Accio! Let me open! Accio! Revelio.
together.
Thank you for coming all this way.
The name's Scrope. Scrope serves the headmaster. Been in the Black family for years. Apologies for the abundance of notes. Scrope wanted to be sure you weren't followed.
What's this all about? Your notes mentioned the book I found in the restricted section.
Scrope can tell you more in exchange for your help, but no one, especially the headmaster, can know.
I'm not so sure about this. I don't need the headmaster upset with me.
Oh, the headmaster won't be upset. Scrope simply wants to surprise him. Scrope will explain. Scrope's late mistress, Apollonia Black, may she rest in peace, was a student at Hogwarts over 50 years ago. Before she died, she spoke with passion of pages ripped from a book. Scrope suspects she took them to her private grotto. She was delirious at the end, poor thing. Mistook Belladonna for elderberries. Scrope tried to warn her.
I'm sorry to hear that. But how do you benefit if I find the pages?
Scrope believes that a treasured Black family ring is also in the grotto. Scrope wishes to give it to the headmaster. Apollonia forbade Scrope from entering the grotto long ago. Scrope continues to honour her wishes. Scrope would not dare ask a student for help, but when Scrope learned you were looking for those pages, Scrope thought you might also find the ring.
It seems this may help us both. I shall do it.
Scrope is relieved. Scrope hoped the young Slytherin would be willing to help. Take this toast to the grotto just down the coast and place it on the pedestal there. Good luck. Scrope will wait right here for you. The best of luck finding your pages and the ring.
Incendio.
Leviosa! Expelliarmus!
Why would I need a piece of toast? I suppose that's where it goes.
Could it be a visitor?
Oh!
Ah! Ooh! Ah! The name's Richard Jackdaw. I was a student, just like you, about a century ago. How in the world did you find this place?
A house elf named Scrope sent me. Said I might find a black family ring here.
Ah. Sorry to say, I sold the ring a long time ago. Poor Scrope. Still holds a candle for Apollonia, I reckon. Can't say I blame him. I stole all these treasures just to impress her. Alas, 'twas to no avail. I thought a secret map I pilfered from Peeves would pique her interest. But she simply rolled her eyes. What would I want with yellowed old pages torn from a book? Not my finest moment.
I'd like to have those pages, if you don't mind.
They're not here. I thought if Apollonia wasn't interested in the map on the pages, perhaps it would lead to something that would intrigue her. So, I followed the map to what I can only describe as an enchanted cave of some kind. And you see what happened next. Here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll show you where to find the pages.
Why did I need the toast to get in here?
Oh, that was Apollonia's idea. Seems some squids love toast. They should have taught you that at Hogwarts.
I think I could guess how you died, but who did it to you?
I was having a look around when I suddenly sensed a refreshing breeze. After that, I felt, well, lightheaded. That's all I remember. Hence, if you do visit the cave, be prepared. I can't tell you what for specifically, but you seem a perceptive sort. Beware a light breeze.
I suppose if that's the only way for me to get those pages, I'll meet you at the forest.
I'm sure the pages are still tucked in my waistcoat. If you don't mind the sight of a, well, my decapitated skeleton, they're yours for the taking.
A map. It doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now. Thanks to you, I was able to enter Apollonia's grotto. The toast was the key. I met a ghost there, Richard Jackdaw, who's agreed to lead me to the pages I've been looking for.
That boy was never good enough for Apollonia. Oh, what of the Black Family ring?
I'm sorry to say that Jackdaw sold it long ago.
Sad news indeed. Scrope shall need to think of another way to impress the headmaster. Scrope takes some consolation in knowing that the young Slytherin found what they needed.
I did. Thank you again, Scrope. You're a credit to House Elves.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. It took the cunning of a Slytherin to track down these pages.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin, or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the birdbath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a
Expelliarmus,
and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Revelio.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu. Is that Latin? Or Greek?
Nothing to do now but keep going. The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw surprisingly as good as his word.
Revelio.
Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Revelio.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. But stand!
Protector! Stupefy!
Incendio!
Well, this first loyalist will report back to Ranrock now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
Revelio.
I wonder how big this place is.
Incendio.
I can shoot the symbol, but it doesn't stay lit for long. Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this. Levioso! Accio!
That platform ought to be able to float straight to me. Well, help myself to this. Accio. I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind me, but where could he be?
Revelio. Revelio.
Incendio!
That's odd. I'd have thought Jack... There's no sign of him. Incendio! Revelio! Accio! Incendio! Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well. Wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Accio! Interested in this loot, but there's no sign of it. There it is. The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. This can't be what beheaded Richard Jackson. Potato! Accio! Yeah. easier. Getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages.
Revelio.
There's Jackdaw looking dead as ever. What happened here? Might it happen again?
Revelio.
Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Potato!
Accio! Expelliarmus! Expelliarmus! Accio! Leviosa! Protego!
Expelliarmus is on the front.
Expelliarmus!
Rebellion. What? That's unnerving. What's happening? I've seen this before. Gringotts and the restricted section. Where am I? Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this?
I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here.
What is this place? Revelio. It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the Map Chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
Handy resource indeed. You're...
Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
The pulso, the banishing charm, useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.
Off on another adventure, are we? Was before I invented flu powder.